Michael's from Richard Diaries, Nova Scotia, 27th of November, 2012. It's my third video today because I watched another movie. I'm revisiting The Hours from 2002 or 2002. Ted and I went to the show to see this. So I read the book before that as well. So now it's the second time I've seen this. And it was very nice revisiting it. It's a slow book. It's a slow movie. Dialogue intensive, relationship issues, so on. So we have Meryl Streep is putting a dinner party on for Ed Harris, who's dying of AIDS, and he has some literary acclaim. That's 2001. There's three stories. Julianne Moore's Laura, and she's in the 1950s in LA, I think. She's married, she has a son. And then Nicole Kidman is playing the author, Virginia Woolf, who committed suicide in 1942, I believe it is. So you've got the three stories intersecting, and they did as well in the book. Okay, Rufus. Rufus likes to try to hone down his nails. Rufus, sit, please. Jeez. I know, you're a sweetie. And Meryl Streep is a lesbian. And Claire Danes plays her daughter. And she, like I said, she's going to put on the party for the Ed Harris character. I'm no good at remembering the names. It's terrible. The Julianne Moore character, Laura, cannot come to terms with being a wife and mother. So she's very, very, very troubled. She's a very nice woman. She's not some kind of monster. And she's married to the talk about doughy face like me, doughy faced John. Oh, what's that fellow's name? John C. Reilly, and how he keeps getting these good looking women in these movies, I don't know. And then Nicole Kidman as the troubled author in England in the culminating in the 1940s. She had lots of bouts of mental illness and so on. And she wrote the book, Mrs. Dalloway, about putting on a dinner party that Laura's reading. And she's putting on a dinner party. So this is where the themes are interconnecting. And she's has some scenes in this that are very, very much like in Mrs. Dalloway, which is a movie I saw several years ago. I think Vanessa Redgrave is Mrs. Dalloway. And it's sad because you've got nobody ends up really happy because of the different circumstances, but they're all trying their best. You know, and I do recommend it for mature viewers. There's nothing vulgar in it. There's certainly no sex in it. Yes, I can't recommend it. No. But it, I think it's a movie that is better enjoyed by somebody who's actually had relationships or had loss or had some kind of bouts of depression or feelings of abandonment as something. Something like that. It's, I think that while the themes may be universal, I'm not so sure that teenagers would necessarily take to this movie if they're self-absorbed and looking for pyrotechnics. I'm not trying to slam intelligent teenagers. I'm just saying it may be as slow as cold molasses otherwise. I find it extremely, extremely engaging. I did read the two-volume biography about Virginia Woolf in, I think, 1976. Very, very famous book written by her nephew, Quentin Bell. two volumes, I think it was. And if I was doing this downstairs in the daylight, I'd be able to find the books and show them to you, but I just can't. And then I read one of her books, The Voyage Out, a few years ago when I was taking the Master's in Humanities. Julianne Moore is one of my favorite actresses, top three. Meryl Streep's very popular, of course. Nicole Kidman I like quite a bit, and she did win the Oscar, as I said, by a nose. They said the nose won the Oscar, she just went along with it. And Virginia Woolf is quite attractive, I think, in her own right, in a very ethereal way, but Nicole Kidman doesn't look anything like Virginia Woolf. You can't make Nicole Kidman ugly, even if you enlarge her nose and make her wear very, very unattractive gingham dresses, you know. But there's the little boy trying to chase his mother, played by Julianne Moore. She's just run away, at least for a while. Anyway, it's such a disjointed but interrelated plot. It's really, really not that easy to discuss without giving away all the plot points. I don't want to do that. Okay? Anyway, I love it. I really, really enjoyed it. This was one of my Blockbuster 10 for $20 DVDs I bought last year when the store was closing. And, I mean, could it be, you know, a better value? And it couldn't. I mean, this movie has a wonderful score by Philip Glass. I do find his music repetitive but engaging. And great photography, a screenplay by David Hare, who I think put Nicole Kidman in her first Broadway play. I think The Blue Room was by David Hare. And wrote Plenty, that Meryl Streep, I think, was in. I think she was in Plenty. But lots of connections there. Anyway, I recommend it. It's a mature film. It's not a vulgar film. But it's kind of a sad film. Okay? Anyway, Michael from Red Chair Diaries, and I'll see you around the tube.